My desk is a mess. Let me just clear away all this stuff quickly. That's better. Now I've got a bit more room for this Dell Latitude 7280. It's currently running Fedora. I have no idea which version is on here. Password is password. And it runs Fedora really well. So let's start off with a quick little tour of this machine. But first, I got to stipulate that this may look fine. Cosmetically, it looks okay. But I do have some issues with it. One is where I think there might be some battery swelling or something, because I find these keys are really stiff down in this part of the keyboard. And two, it has intermittent starting issues. So sometimes when I start it, I press the on button, it doesn't always boot. So I got to figure out what that is. But this is a machine that I'll probably be putting on eBay as well too. i5 7th gen, really nice. But still, let's get into it really quick. So here on the right side, we'll see a headphone microphone jack, an SD card reader, what looks like an optional SIM card tray. Over here, you have a USB port. And there you'll have your Ethernet port and what looks like a lock right there. And the power supply is here, the power supply, the on-off button. Now here on the left side, we have the power supply, a USB-C port right there, a full-size HDMI, and another USB port here, along with the ever-present but completely useless smart card reader. And now along the bottom, there are a pair of speakers. Now this speaker grill right here, it almost, I can't tell if it's full of something or looks like metal shards almost. Yeah, see? Looks like little, I don't know what these are. Oh, it's magnetic. There's something stuck there. I don't know what these are. Looks like metal shards. That could explain a few issues. Now, the lid of this machine does have a few scratches. It's like a carbon fiber look. It looks pretty modern. Actually, I really like the look. And this machine is meant to compete, I guess, with the Lenovo X270, thanks to its really tiny size. I believe that's a 12-inch screen, but I'll have to find it for sure. It might be a 13. Nice hinges, really nice keyboard. I do prefer the Lenovo keyboard, but overall, it's really a nice, well-sized machine. Like I said, comfortable keyboard, but I don't think it's in the same quality as Lenovo. Maybe it's because of the issues I'm having with these keys down here. Okay, let's take it apart and see if we can figure out what the issue is. Now, like I said, it is running Fedora. And one thing I do like about Fedora is the touchscreen, the trackpad commands you have here. You can see you can three fingers on and you can do that. You can do this. Really nice operating system. Let's go down here and go into settings really quick. And we'll go into about. So this is the 7280. It's firmware 1.93, 8 gigs of RAM. This is an i5 7200 processor, 4 core. The graphics card says HD graphics 620. Disk capacity 256.1. And this is Fedora Linux 38 Workstation Edition, 64-bit. Really nice machine. I'm really happy with that. And the screen, the display itself, I believe is 1920 by 1080, which you can't see it, but it's right there. We'll come back later and test out the camera if I remember. Oh! Forgot that I left this thing on. That's not normally how I look. Okay, no effect. That's a crisp picture. I don't think you can argue with that picture at all. That looks pretty nice. Can I make it any bigger? Does it go any larger? Okay, there we go. All right, so no complaints with Fedora. It seems to be running that fairly well. So the resolution is 1280 by 720. And the photo is 1280 by 720. And that's using the integrated webcam. All right, well, that seems to work pretty good. No complaints with that. I've been using it now for, geez, probably 2 days on the battery. And the battery is still at 68%. All right, let's turn it off. And hopefully it will restart, but then we'll open it up. Power off. Really power off? Yes, really power off. Okay, let's flip it over, open it up, see what we got in here, and take a look. I would always recommend getting yourself a magnetic screw holder. And get started. Okay, I noticed there's a crack up here. We can see it stayed there. Okay, so that is broken. What do we have here? Well, we have your NVMe drive right there, so that is replaceable. Just stick a RAM right here. This is probably the 8 gig. 8 gig PC4 2400. That's the only slot I see, though. Now, we do have a WAN slot here with the 10 already. We have your WLAN slot there. That CMOS battery is down here. See this speaker? Like I said, it's got, well, since it's magnetic, there's a magnet inside the speaker. Maybe that's where these little round pebbles are coming from. They almost look like bearings out of something. They're definitely metal, though, because they just stuck right to that magnet. Everything looks normal. The battery doesn't feel swollen or look swollen. So I don't think that's the issue. Physically, it seems to be fine. Could be water damage. It could be a bunch of things that may be impacting the way it starts. But that's what it looks like internally. Yeah, there's like a fine grit on top of these. All right, let's put it back together and see if it actually starts this time. So I put it all together. Let's just see if it actually does start here, because this is where I've been having the issues. I know there's over half of the battery left. I think there's like 60-something percent. So I'm going to press the power button here. You see the light comes on. Let's see if this keyboard is lit up. See, I don't see any action, though. The light is on here, but I don't see any signs of it booting. Why is it doing that? It's literally, last time I had to try turning it on and off 3 times. And here's one of my issues with this power button. When you go to press it on and off, and let's say I'm going to press to hold it. Usually you can press and hold a power button for 5 seconds to turn it off. Well, when I press and hold it, I can't see the light on there. See that little light built into the power button? See how it's off now? So who knows what happened there, but we'll try it again. On. See, it's not even turning on now. Oh, wait, and now I get this little flashing light down here. So one white, one amber, two amber, one white. Two amber, one white. What does that mean? Let's check out Google to see. Okay, so two amber, one white means that it could be a possible CPU issue according to the Dell support website here. So when I'm clicking that power button and trying to turn it on, there's a possibility that the CPU is failing. So is that an easy fix? I don't think that's going to be an easy fix. This is going to be a parts machine. It's literally a 1 in 5 chance or less, 1 in 3, that this machine is going to turn on at all. Okay, well, final thoughts. If it wasn't for the CPU issue on this, this would be a really nice machine. But this isn't that old. This is like a 2017 model, I think. And it's just giving me some issues. So I'm wondering now maybe if this area of the sticky of the keys could be maybe fluid is dumped on there. Maybe that's where the processor issue happened. Hard to say. I'm not going to fix it. I'm going to sell it as is for parts probably and see what we can do with it. But that is the Dell 7280 really nice machine if it's working. This one, you know, it's nice and turns on. And it runs Fedora really well. So if you're thinking of getting a Linux on a Dell product like this, Fedora seems to run really well, no issues. Okay, that's it. If you like these kind of videos, I have a whole bunch of other Linux-based videos here. Just click on one of those. Let me know what you think. I will put the listing link for this one down below, down there, in my eBay listing, my eBay store. And we'll talk again. Thanks for watching.